Hello friends, myself Dr. Dipali Gupta. I'm working as Professor Research in Chitkara University Research and Innovation Network of Chitkara University, Punjab. Today we are going to discuss about cyclomatic complexity metrics. I'll be covering the following contents: introduction to software metrics, followed by attributes of software metrics, and then cyclomatic complexity metrics. So before we discuss cyclomatic complexity metrics, let us first understand the term software metrics. Software metrics can be defined as quantitative measure of degree to which a system, component, or process possess a given attribute. The continuous application of these software metrics to software development process helps to improve that process and its products. These software metrics are applicable to all the phases of SDLC, right from feasibility study to maintenance phase, in order to improve the development process on a continuous basis. In order to be effective, software metrics should be simple and their computation should not require inordinate time and effort. They should be empirically and intuitively persuasive, that is, they should satisfy an engineer's intuitive notion about the product attribute under consideration. It should yield consistent results. It should be independent of the programming language used and should be consistent in the use of units and dimensions. Now, McCabe's cyclomatic complexity metrics. As the name suggests, it was proposed by McCabe's in the year 1976. Cyclomatic complexity is a software metric used to measure the complexity of a program. It is a quantitative measure of the number of linearly independent paths through a program's source code. This complexity matrix can be computed with the help of control flow graph. So, the most basic question here is that what exactly is a control flow graph and what does it indicates? A control flow graph indicates how the control flows through the program, which in turn is a sequence in which different instructions of a program get executed when test cases are executed. So, control flow graph is a representation which make use of graphical notations to represent all the paths that might be traversed through a program during its execution. Look at the figure shown here. It is a control flow graph where red circles represents nodes and directed arrows represent edges of a control flow graph. Now, the next question is how to draw a control flow graph. So, given a program, the first basic step is to number all the statements of a program. Then these numbered statements are represented by nodes of control flow graph. And after that, draw an edge from one node to another node. Now let us look at this case. We'll try to convert this source code into control flow graph. We have not numbered this first statement here because anyway that will get executed. And rest ones we have numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now these numbered statements will become nodes in the control flow graph. After numbering these statements, the next step is to draw a node corresponding to every statement. That is, for statement 1, we'll draw a node 1. Similarly, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Next step is to draw an edge from one node to another node. When we see the execution of a statement representing the node when transfer control to another node. So in this case, we have at first while loop. So either the condition can be true or the condition can be false. So if the condition is true, then the control will be transferred from statement 1 to statement 2. So we'll draw an edge from node 1 to node 2. And if the condition is false, then the control will be transferred from 1 to 6. So we'll draw an edge from 1 to 6. Now we come to second statement. This is also a decision statement wherein the control can either transfer from 2 to 3 or from 2 to 4. So which I have represented here as an edge between 2 to 3 and 2 to 4. So this is the basic idea. So in this way we have drawn an edges between 3 to 5, 4 to 5 and 5 to 1. So in this way you can convert any source code into control flow graph. Now, given a control flow graph G of a program, the cyclomatic complexity is denoted by VG, which can be computed as VG is equal to E minus N plus 2, where E is the number of edges and N is the number of nodes. So let's discuss this with an example. We'll compute the value of VG using three alternate methods, that is method 1, 2 and method 3. So we'll consider a control flow graph given in this figure, which has four cases. Case A for normal sequence of flow, case B while loop, case C if then else, and case D until. So let us first compute value of VG using method 1, wherein we'll use the formula E minus N plus 2, where E is the number of edges and N is the number of nodes. Now let's consider case A. Let us count the number of edges. So clearly there is only one edge, so value of E becomes 1. And there are two nodes, so value of N becomes 2. Putting the value of E and N in the formula, 1 minus 2 plus 2 is equal to 1. Now consider second case, we'll count the number of edges, 1, 2 and 3. So there are 3 edges and 1, 2 and 3. There are 3 nodes. So putting the value of E and N, 3 minus 3 plus 2, VG comes out to be 2. Now consider the third case, that is C. Count the number of edges, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So there are 4 edges and 4 nodes. So 4 minus 4 plus 2 is 2. So value for VG is 2 in this case. Now consider the next case. Count the number of edges, 1, 2 and 3, and nodes, 1, 2 and 3. So 3 minus 3 plus 2 is 2. Now let us compute the value of VG using the second method, and the formula for the same is VG is equal to total number of bounded areas plus 1. So in the first case, that is case A, there is no bounded area, so value for bounded area is 0. So 0 plus 1 is 1. Now second case, this is clearly a bounded area, so value for bounded area is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. So value for VG becomes 2. Now in this case, this is a bounded area, so VG is equal to 1 plus 1, that means 2. In the D case, this is a bounded area, so 1 plus 1 is 2. Now we'll discuss the third method. The formula to compute VG is P plus 1, where P is equal to number of predicate nodes. And what are predicate nodes? Predicate nodes are the nodes that contains conditions. That means, say for instance, let us consider this node. Is this a predicate node? Yes, it is a predicate node because it has two edges coming in outward directions. So, two edges coming in outward direction. So, this is a predicate node. So, let us consider case A. Consider this node. This has only one directed edge coming in outward direction. So, this is not a predicate node. And this is also not a predicate node. So, there is no predicate node. So, value of P becomes 0. That means VG is equal to 0 plus 1 is 1. Which is also same as computed using method 1 and 2. Now, consider the case B. This is a predicate node. Let us see. There is one edge and the second is coming in outward direction. So, this is a predicate node. Yes. So, value for P becomes 1 here. This is a predicate node. No, because it has only one edge coming in outward direction. This is not a predicate node. And similarly, this is not a predicate node. So, value for P is only 1 in this case. So, putting the value of P in this formula, VG is equal to 1 plus 1 is 2. Now, consider the third case. Is this a predicate node? Yes, because it has two edges coming in outward direction. So, this is a predicate node. Now, consider this node. This has only one edge coming in outward direction. This is not a predicate node. This is also not a predicate node. Only one edge is coming out and no edge is coming out. So, this is not a predicate node. So, value of predicate node is 1 in this case. So, putting the value of P over here, 1 plus 1 is 2. VG becomes 2. Now, the last case, case D, this is a predicate node, one edge is coming out, so this is not a predicate node. Is this a predicate node? Yes, two edges are coming out, 1 and 2. So, this is a predicate node. So, this is not a predicate node, so value of P becomes 1 here. Putting the value of P here, VG is equal to 1 plus 1 is 2. So, clearly we can see that the value of VG remains same whether we compute it using method 1, 2 or method 3. So, we can use any of these methods as the result remains same in all the three methods. Let us take another example, example 2, wherein we have been given a control flow graph and will compute the value of VG using the three alternative methods. Now, the first method E minus N plus 2. So, count the number of edges 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Value of E becomes 6. Now, note 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, N becomes 6. 6 minus 6 plus 2 is 2. Second method VG is equal to total number of bounded areas plus 1. How many bounded areas? There is only one bounded area. So, 1 plus 1 is 2. Now, the third method, VG is equal to P plus 1. P is predicate nodes. This is a predicate node? No, because it has only one edge coming in outward directions. Is this a predicate node? Yes, because it has two edges coming in outward direction. So, value of P becomes 1 here. Is this a predicate node? No, only one edge is coming in outward direction. This is also not a predicate node. Only one edge is coming outward direction. This is also not a predicate node and this is also not a predicate node. So, 2 is the only predicate node here. So, value of P becomes 1 here. That means 1 plus 1 is 2. So, clearly you can see that VG remains same whether we use any one of the three methods, that is method 1, 2 and method 3. So, this was all about cyclomatic complexity. I hope the concept of cyclomatic complexity is clear to you by now, and we'll discuss few more software metrics in the upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.